Hello friends, this is the 7th part of the video of gas filled neutron detectors. In this video we will see helium-3 detectors. So let's start. First we will see the construction of helium-3 detectors. Here I have shown the periphery in green color, that is nothing but the cathode. Inside the cathode there is a gas field, that is helium-3. Then we have the anode, and in the black color I have shown the insulator materials. And if we connect a high voltage between anode to cathode, we can analyze the number of counts produced by the detector. So let's see the working principle. If the neutron will come, it will interact with the helium, and subsequently it will generate two fragments, that is hydrogen plus tritium, and those two fragments can ionize the gas, and the ion pair will be collected at the cathode and the electrons will be collected at the anode, and we'll have the current flow or the pulse between the anode to cathode. So below the figure I have shown the complete equation of helium interacts with neutron, it will generate the hydrogen plus tritium plus 765 keV of energy, which will be distributed among the two fragments. And I have also shown the figure, the capacitor from which we can tap the signal, and if we tap the signal from cathode it will be of non-inverted, and if we tap it from the anode it will be of inverted pulse, that we have already seen in the previous videos and discussed about it also. So now we will see the capture cross section of helium-3, that is 5330 bonds, where one bond is equal to 1 into 10 raised to power minus 24 centimeter square, and if we convert 8 into meter square, then 1 into 10 raised to power minus 28 meter square. So the region of operation of helium-3 detector is mostly ionization region, and we can also use it in gigamolar region also, and if there is no gamma present then we can use it in gigamolar region, and if we want to operate it in current mode we have to use it in ionization region. Then we'll see the materials. Anode is made up of tungsten, as we need a thin wire, and that should be strong enough, so that's why we select tungsten as a material for anode. Cathode we are using aluminium, insulator we are using ceramic, as we want a very less current to be flow between anode to cathode, leakage to be less, so high insulation resistance material, so hence we are selecting L2O3. Gas we are using helium-3, and I think we have learned sufficient about helium-3 detectors. Hope you like this video. Thank you.